Like so many days during the past 5 years, it's been one of waiting and hoping for news at Lambeth Palace, from where Terry Waite was sent on his mission. Today, Lord Runcie, the former Archbishop of Canterbury, recalled how Terry's plight moved the nation and people he met on his travels abroad.
I would be walking in the streets of an African township or in Chicago, and people would come up to me and say, any news about Terry? You know, they wouldn't need any preliminary. That was an international sort of question. Any news about Terry? And so I've been encouraged through darker periods by that.
As the news came through that Terry Waite had finally been freed, there was joy and celebration from Lambeth Palace to his friends and family.
AP in Beirut say, Terry Waite is free.
Oh my God. Oh God. I've thought about this for so long, for 5 years.
At Lambeth Palace, staff and journalists gathered eager for the latest news. Behind the scenes, the palace have worked tirelessly to try to secure the release, both through political and religious sources. A short time ago, Archbishop George Carey emerged on the palace steps.
The prayers of so many people have been answered today, and we thank God for news of his release. It's also a great joy that Tom Sutherland has been released as well. We're delighted and especially joyful for Frances and her family. They're born this period of captivity with great dignity and fortitude.
Tonight, the news couldn't be better. Terry Waite is finally on his way home. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.